Another very widely used regularization technique, particularly with convolutional neural nets, is dropout. In dropout, during training for each mini batch, misspelled there, what we're going to do is pick a fraction, usually a half, of the nodes in the neural net and drop them out. Temporarily remove the node and all of the weights coming in and out of it. Now train your resultant half of a neural net here with standard stochastic gradient descent for one mini batch. Then put back in all of the weights that you had removed. Randomly pick another half of the nodes to drop out. Sampling with replacement is called. Again, do a mini batch, gradient descent, repeat, repeat, repeat. So what we're doing is every epoch, every mini batch, dropping out a different set of nodes and then doing a step. So we're bouncing the network all over the place. At the end of the day, we put back in the last set of nodes that we had deleted. So we now have the full network. Every node now is getting here twice as many inputs as it was getting during the training when half of them were deleted. So we're going to shrink the input, divide it by a half, right? Shrink them by P. So we compensate for the fact that at the end we put in lots of, twice as many to be precise, inputs as we had during training. This dropout procedure seems incredibly ad hoc, but it actually has quite nice theory. It samples, in theory, over exponentially many networks, sort of like doing an ensemble of networks. You might want to build thousands of networks and then average them all. That works very well in theory, but in practice is too expensive. But doing the dropout bounces out of these different pieces. It samples the networks. It avoids local minima. It avoids converging to tight minima. And in practice, works extremely well. It's widely used. Occasionally, people do dropout on some of the layers and not on other ones. There's lots of choices. But in general, particularly for convolutional neural nets, dropout leads to better solutions. So what is it doing? Adding noise, preventing overfitting by breaking brittle, by neuro overfit predictions. It tends to make sure that the signal is spread over lots of the neurons. If you don't have dropout, some neurons end up getting a zero output. They just become frozen at useful pieces. It forces a distributed representation that uses all of the nodes, because if some neurons weren't used, well, they're going to be forced to be used in the various dropout ones. And by forcing these dead branches, these unused neurons to work, it gives more generalizable, stable predictions.